Impeachment, it seems to me, basically falls into two basic categories. One is, this is a great chance for me to burnish my bona fides as a lunatic to my constituents and either both ensure that I'm going to get reelected and no one's ever going to challenge me again in this seat, or maybe give me a future in Republican, in broader Republican politics, to the extent that there will be one. And here is a clip from Doug Collins in the House Rules hearing. This is the Rules Committee was setting the rules for impeachment ahead of the, you know, and they're having a debate on the rules of impeachment. This committee is chaired by Jim McGovern, Worcester's finest. Love it. And listen to Doug Collins try and respond to a simple question as to, do you think that what Trump did, because nobody's disputing the actual facts, right? Nobody's saying, like, he never called Zelensky. He never said investigate Biden or Burisma or any of these things. And he never said, like, he never held back the money. Nobody's saying that. So the question is, like, do you think it's appropriate? Like, give me a sense of, like, where on, like, a scale of 1 to 10. How appropriate is this call? And watch Doug Collins try and answer this question.
And to explain what happened.
And Mr. Collins, I'll ask you and Mr. Eskin the same question. I mean, was the president's call with President Zelensky perfect, as the president has said? And was it appropriate for him to ask another country to investigate an American citizen?
I find there was nothing, I've said this before, there's nothing wrong with the call. And then when you look at it, and again, I'm frankly the last... The problem we're having right now is exactly the last 15 minutes of this. Great oratory on a lot of things that mean nothing to this actual impeachment. I mean, we get down to the bottom line here, and I'm just leave it at that. Let him answer that question. I'll get back to it later, because everything that's been thrown out here is exactly what the problem we've had in the discussion. And this idea of throwing law, in fact, we've disproven the facts. We've talked about the law and broken. They didn't put it in the Constitution. So I can yell on both of them. I can talk about both of them. The problem we have here is this is the very problem we have. And I'll just address one thing before I let it back. Or if you want me to switch right now, I will.
No, I mean, that's okay. Fine.
I'll give it to him.
I mean, that's fine. I mean, I'm looking at, you know, the president and the transition.
Yeah, there
if
he
you're
is.
Watching on YouTube, Doug Collins did that to the video.
Yeah, you can't really see what he's saying. But he couldn't answer, and then finally just landed on pass. Wish we could see that again, because the look on his face, he looks like he's a deer in the headlights there. But Doug Collins trying to answer the simple question, like, how would you assess what he did? And they'll talk about process. And they'll talk about lack of testimony from Adam Schiff. We watched all the hearings.